BBC introducing In Hereford and Worcester
with Andrew Marston. Unsigned,
undiscovered, and under the radar music.
So, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Kidderminster College. It gives me great pleasure to introduce the first acts here today. Actually come across them as a different group a few years back called Dead Letter Office. They're in fact students here a few years ago. They're still based in the local area, and their debut album called Get Well Soon was actually recorded and mixed all in their homes. Their influences are as diverse as Blur, Joy Division and Simply Red. They're Rubicava!
Thank you. show you how it feels. Throw your arms around the world and feel nothing. I'll savor every meal till the queen has come along. Until I kill my bird. You understand. You skip town when they ran out of safety net. You were as graceful as a moth, and as poisonous as bleach. A murderer between the sheets. Well, the confidence is a lie. You should go.
I'm bound to ask him, Rubicava, what does that mean?
It's a very obscure reference from an old video game called Grim Fandango. It makes us out to be significant nerds. We're really not that bad.
But you all understood what this was.
Well, I was totally clueless.
How did you all meet? Because some of you were in Dead Letter Office before.
Us two. And then we met Kyle just through mutual friends in the pub, as all the great meetings take place in the pub. And then we actually put out a flyer for this one.
Yeah, for the uni. The band sounded like the kind of thing I wanted to be in. And then it turned out we happened to be like on the same course as well. And Benj lives literally right around the corner from me.
So you were originally, what, here at Kidderminster College and studied at Worcester Uni?
These two were at Kiddie College.
We were at Kiddie College again, and that's how we started the first band, which fell into disrepute. I don't actually understand why. I think it's just, you know, people moved on and life gets in the way, doesn't it?
So what is life doing for you guys at the moment? What do you do when you're not in the band?
Office manager. Adult education, we look after apprenticeships and stuff like that, getting people into work if they're unemployed.
I'm training to be a primary school teacher.
Just finished uni. I've got two young kids, so I just found the first job I could get, really.
I'm an SEO copywriter. If you don't know what that is, you don't want to know, because it's the most boring thing you mainly imagine.
Search engine optimization.
Yeah, all right, so...
I went on the same course.
Oh, really? This is a lot more fun. Especially okay. Today, this was like a completely new experience for us. We've never really done anything like this.
So what's your plans with the band then?
We spent the last year with finishing the album, when we took it and on what we'd like to call our own mini tour, where we just went to wherever would have us, really. Now we've finished that, I think we want to try and look at either getting in a studio and working on another release, or doing something proper. I mean, we want to try and get some kind of label interest. We've done the whole thing ourselves and it's worked for us so far, so we'll just keep going with it and see what happens.
Well, I described you on the radio as one of the hottest acts that I've come across in the last 12 months or so. But you managed to record all of this, what, at home, isn't it?
We got a lot of complaints from the neighbours, I'll say that much. No, literally, I think they hate me now. Well, we recorded all
so
the
they
drums.
Haven't bought the album?
I think I sort of took it around as a peace offering to see if they wanted to have it. No, I think they'd have much preferred like some roses and a box of chocolates. It's a great record considering we did it ourselves. We're really proud of it. Literally every review we've got from it has been like, you know, flawless, stunning, great. Just nobody's bought it. It's like, it's critically applauded but commercially underperforming.
Where can you buy
it? Or change
it,
your life.
Where can you buy it?
Everywhere. Like iTunes and
Rise in Worcester as well.
Just go on our website or just type Rubicava into Google and we're the only thing that comes up. That's the great thing about having such an obscure name.
It's your
name.
Search engine optimization training that
that's
came
what it is.
Into effect there.
Maybe subliminally that's where the name came from. Why did something so bizarre? Yeah.
So where did you record the drums?
In my conservatory. we hung up loads of like sheets. Well, because me and Jevon did a music technology course here, actually here at Kiddy College, we know something about recording. So basically we used all the training we gathered here. Everyone sort of commented on it being, you know, quite a professional sounding record considering it was done under such financially tight circumstances.
It was in the conservatory in the middle of summer and we had duvets and sheets on all of the walls and it was just like a little sweatbox.
We were in there for a good week just doing
the right snare sound.
Did it multi-track or did you kind of record it all as a band?
Multi-tracking, we did it through Logic, but we couldn't get the right snare sound, so we had to tape Matt's wallet to the snare drum. For some reason that gave us a really great snare sound.
Didn't we have to put socks on the sticks as well for one of the soft tom sounds?
Okay. Yeah. Wow, some recording advice there. Use socks and a wallet.
You know, Scott Walker beats big slabs of pork on his records. We use socks and wallets.
Well, well played today, and thanks for coming down.
Cheers. Thanks for having us.
Listen to the best interviews online. bbc.co.uk/Hereford and Worcester/introducing.
Thank you.
Sharpen his teeth, a loose. not show it on my back. But I'd be lost without showing.
Solar resistance. This is called Autopilot.
Like an insect, spend your poison and you die. A lucky fool, made up of recycled dreams. Built together at the seams on a factory farm vacation with the fear of God in your eyes. I saw you in a good light. Don't feel it, you're bluffing, I can how he'd sing from the choir. Turn it up. You used to think that you'd end it, but now you know that you're right. Turn it up.
We've got in our area right now. Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise one more time. Rubicava!
Unsigned, undiscovered,
and under the radar music.
Yeah, quite good. I've seen them a few times.
And where have you seen them before, by the way?
Stourbridge, Kidderminster, I think I saw them in Worcester as well. So I've seen them quite a few times.
I think they're really good. I mean, I heard quite a lot about them from other people who I know have seen them, and I thought they were really good.
Is this your first time at Kidderminster College?
Yeah, it's not quite what I was expecting. It's a lot bigger than what I was expecting.
Oh, that's good.
Hi, my name's Claire. I'm from Stourbridge. I think they're absolutely brilliant. They're really different from anything else that's out there. I think the vocals are amazing and the stuff they write is just superb.
I'm Claire Grant and I'm from Kidderminster.
And this first time you've been to Kidderminster College?
Yes, for a long, long time.
And what did you think of Rubicava?
Absolutely fantastic. I like the mix of the slow and the fast songs, so they're fantastic.
Hello, what's your name and where are you from?
Mike Whitbread, I'm a musician myself and it was a very good band. The last track was absolutely superb.
What sort of music do you like listening to yourself?
Generally, rock music. Brilliant sets, a brilliant venue.
Hello, what's your name and where are you from?
Kerry from Stourbridge.
And what do you think of Rubicava?
Brilliant.
I'm Debbie and I'm from Stourbridge. We've seen Rubicava quite a few times and we absolutely think they're brilliant.
Ah, you've got the T-shirt.
Rock music, but loud rock music.
I thought they were good, actually. I thought they were a very tight rhythm section, good vocals as well, good harmonies. I don't know if they write their own material. They were quite good songs as well.
Oh, yes, it's all original stuff. And you say you're a musician yourself. What sort of music?
A singer-songwriter, really, so I write my own material.
Have you sent any of your stuff into our show?
No, I haven't.
Oh.
No.
I'll have to go have a word with this chap a little bit later, I think.
I'm Jo Watson, I'm married to Adrian, and I'm from Kidderminster area as well.
Is this your first time at Kidderminster College?
Yes, in its present form. I've been before when it was in Cui Road, in the old one, but not to the new one.
And what do you think of Rubicava?
I really enjoyed them. I'm not a great one for very loud music. It was just about on my limit, but I thought it was great rhythm.
I'm Brad, I'm from Worcester.
First time at Kidderminster College, Brad?
No, I'm a student at Kidderminster College doing music.
And what do you think of Rubicava?
Yeah, they're really good. Very atmospherical. if that's a word.
I'm Harvey Jones, I'm from Worcester. No, I'm a student here as well.
And what do you study?
I study music performance. They were great, yeah, I really liked it.
BBC introducing In Hereford and Worcester.
With Andrew Marston.
Be part of it.